Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the Vue Tab component in a Vue application. The Tabs component is a simple user interface for organizing related content in a compact space with a rich set of features such as animation, orientation, templating, a close button, a scroll bar, or pop-up, and more. In this video, I will show you how to create a Vue app and add the Vue Tab component to it. You will see how to customize the tab header position and set styles to the active tab header. I will also show how to render the tab component using HTML elements and display the overflowing headers. I'm going to create a Vue application using the Vue vite command. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Vue and Node.js. I edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output on a supported browser. To create a project in Vue, I open Visual Studio Code and type the command npm create vite at latest. Then I provide the app name, my Vue app. Here, I choose the framework as Vue and the variant as JavaScript. Now the Vue project is created. I navigate to the newly created Vue app and install the required dependencies using the npm install command. Now the application is configured with the default settings of a Vue project. To add the Syncfusion Vue tab component, install the Syncfusion Vue navigations package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-navigations --save. This command will install the Vue navigations package along with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, the application is ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. So, I open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, it is required to register the Vue license key. To know how to generate this license key, refer to the link attached in the description below. Now I will start to add the tab component. So let me open the app.vue file and remove the default code. Then, I import the tab component, tab items directive, and tab item directive from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue navigations package. Then, I add the component by adding the EJS tab tag. Next, to add tab items, I define the etab items tag, which accepts n number of etab item definitions. Here I want to display information about two different programming languages. So let me define two etab item tags. To set the header texts to these tab items, I define a constant variable and set the text to ASP.NET. Similarly, I define header text for the other tab item. I then assign these header texts to the header property of the component. Next, I need to add content to these tab items. For that, I define a constant variable and add the appropriate content. Similarly, I add content to the other tab item. I assign this content to the component using the content property. To align the tab content, define the CSS class property with an appropriate class name to override a few CSS styles. Also, I need to define CSS reference for the tab component, so let me import the material theme inside the style tag. I have also referred CSS to the other dependent components like buttons and pop-ups. Along with this, I define a few CSS styles for this tab content class. I will save the changes and run the application using the npm run dev command. You can see the tab component is rendered with two tab items. The default position of the tab header is the top. Apart from this default position, it also supports left, right, and bottom. To change the position, I use the header placement property. In this example, I will set the header placement to left. See now, the header items are on the left side of the tab. Next, I will show you how to apply styles to the header. To apply a specific style, you can either set a predefined or custom class to the tab root element. The available predefined classes are efill, ebackground, and ebackground eaccent. I am going to set a background color to the active tab header by assigning the predefined class efill to the CSS class property. And now see the active tab header has a background color. Next, I will show you how to initialize the tab component using HTML elements. First, I need to remove the existing tab items and add HTML division elements with class attributes. These etab header and econtent classes will add all required styles to display the HTML elements as tab headers and content. I then set the appropriate header text and content for these division elements. For better clarity, I will place the header in its default position by removing the header placement property. Looking at the component now, it displays headers and content rendered from the HTML elements. If you display more tab items in the tab component, there is a chance that the header items will overflow the available space. In this case, you need to specify the appropriate tab display mode. By default, when you add more tabs, the tab component makes the overflowing items scrollable. To demonstrate this, I set the width property to 850 pixels and show you how this default scrollable mode works. I define more division elements here and set the appropriate header and content to it. Looking at the component now, the tab header items are displayed in a single line with horizontal scrolling enabled at both ends of the header. To display those overflowing tab items in a popup, I set the overflow mode property to popup. See, when I click the down arrow, the overflowing tab header items move to the popup container like this. In this video, I have shown you how to create a Vue project and how to add the Syncfusion Vue Tab component to it. You also saw how to change the tab header position and set styles to an active tab header. Finally, I demonstrated how to add content using HTML elements and display the overflowing headers using popup. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Vue products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.